So, local time, 1:15 in the afternoon as we get underway with the penultimate race of the 2021 season for DD2. Here's your starting grid. On pole position, it is Mika Metz in the 464 with Fabian Vock in the 481 alongside. Row 2, it's Hannes Border in the 468 and Mark Bartels in the 488 alongside. Yannick Jacobs in the 401. We'll be joined on row 3 by in the 439. Orion Bide in the 433 starts on the inside of row 4 and has the 409 of Tim Stender alongside. Dennis Thiem in the number 454 and Jan Stier in the 444 round out the top 10. Row 6, it's Tristan Gebhardt and Dion Arndt in the 405 and the 442 respectively. Denis Schallow, Alex Fehlenbach, Marcel Steinert and Robert Schorpien. Now, Robert Schorpien, that is an interesting development, because what did happen, just going to have a look here. So it was a technical, it was a disqualification through technical for Robert Schorpien. So he starts right from the back of the grid. So that effectively gave Mika Metz the race victory from earlier on today. So this could be the defining moment for Mika Metz. Fabian Bock is alongside. So effectively, Bock, that's quite an interesting one, isn't it? So 50 points secured by Mika Metz, 40 points today secured by, well, 40 points this weekend secured by Fabian Bock. I don't think, is that going to be a clean start? Well, I'm just waiting for the timer to reset, because I think that was, yeah, that's a, that to me, I think was a full start. Yellow flags are out on the circuit. So that to me says full start, called by race control. Timer has been reset. And commonly in Rotax racing circles, if we get two full starts, what will happen is we'll get a red flag. So 14 minutes reset on the clock. So Mika Metz and Fabian Bock will control pace here at Wittgenborn. Plus one additional lap. We are ready to get the afternoon's action underway here at Wittgenborn. Into the tram lines, revs rise. Are we off and away? Looks like that might be the case. Well, I'm not too sure, because I think that could have been a bit of a difficult start there. But however, it looks like they've let them go. There's no sort of rainfall forecasted until about 3 o'clock, or 4 o'clock, or 3 o'clock this afternoon local time. But at the moment, Mika Metz is leading the way. Whether that has changed or not is anyone's guess, mine included. So they are about to cross the line to complete the very first lap of this race, with 13 minutes on the clock to go. So Mika Metz has now got what is effectively a nigh on 2 second gap between himself and Fabian Bock, who is leading the way. So we have had 16 drivers start this race. It's getting a bit treacherous out there. I'm just wondering looks like there might be a slight damp shower because we're running in the 57s. Well, that's what Mika Metz is running in. So that says to me, so I would imagine, just judging by that pace, well, the pace looks to be accelerating, but drivers are losing a little bit of traction, going a little bit sideways through the first corner. Florent Seyfried being one of them, who's currently sitting behind Dennis Thiem in fourth and Hannes Bader in third place. So still very much a bone of contention as to whether these drivers are at, well, if they're at full racing speed based on the conditions. That's what it looks like to me, because some of the drivers are running, well, the pace is now increasing, which is a good thing. I think the tyres are coming up to temperature. And we're about close to being 3 minutes into this race. But Bobo Chorpion has been making his way through the field, and he is closing in on, of all people, Florian Breidenbach. So that has helped Chorpion's run. Now, he would have had a victory had it not been for a technical, scrutineering check, which saw him being disqualified. And it is changing all the time. Hannes Bader staying now ahead of Dennis Thiem. Here comes Florent Seyfried side by side. The pair nearly clash wheels. Dennis Thiem stays in front. There's Mark Bartels, and here comes Yannick Jacobs. Jacobs, two wheels on the grass, going through the final left-hander, gets through on Bartels. That was a very, very cheeky move there, as Dennis Thiem still ahead of Florent Seyfried. Seyfried manages to get through, going through turn four. So gets a good run there. Looks like Yannick Jacobs might be trying to get through on Dennis Thiem as well. A little bit further back, we've got the likes of Tim Stender, Alex Fehlenbach, Leon Arndt, Jana Stier down in 13th position. And this battle that is raging on in front of us is Florian Breidenbach past Mark Bartels, with Robert Chorpion, who was quickly closing in on them. Ahead they've got Yannick Jacobs in sixth, Florent Seyfried in fifth. Mika Metz is leading by a considerable margin. Fabian Box just put in the fastest lap of the race, of 52.099. That is nearly a second quicker than Mika Metz. Mika Metz has got just over 9 minutes plus an additional lap. This is effectively the final designated race for this race meeting. But then we've got the one for Varkasdorf still to go. But Mika Metz is doing exactly what he needs to do. Stay out in front, keep leading. This is a great battle here between Hannes Bader, Florent Seyfried, and Yannick Jacobs. This is for P3 on the road. And at the minute, the way things stands, Yannick Jacobs is showing a good turn of pace. He did a very, very... He's done exactly the same thing, just nipping a little bit of the grass going through the final corner. Thing was, is that he managed to, you know, he wasn't incurring, it's like literally like a graze, so to speak. That's why it's keeping him in proximity. Marcel Steinert has now made his way up to 13th past Jana Stier. Denis Chalot was now behind Tristan Gebhardt. Robert Chopin passed Mark Bartels in the meantime. And now the 477 on the Mach 1 chassis, now up into what is P7 on the road. So we're fast approaching the halfway point of this race, and it looks to be, in principle, some people might think it's a foregone conclusion. Well, I don't think that yet, because anything can happen. We have halfway down, we've got halfway to go. 7 minutes on the clock in this race remaining. Drivers are now, it looks like the track's come back to them a little bit, because Mika Metz has just gone and put in a 49.655. Hannes Border in third place is now fastest of anybody, and has just put in a 49.404 second lap time. Yannick Jacobs rounds out the top four. Everyone has improved and put in a personal best lap time after eight completed laps, just over 8 kilometres of racing. Best part of 8.2 kilometres so far have been completed. And we did see in the first race earlier on that the DD2 drivers were the ones that got put like a rock under a hard place. It begged the question as to how changeable were the weather conditions going to be today. And it has been variable. We've had some very, very good racing in the dry, but we have had racing where it's been mixed conditions, intermixed conditions, where we've had a nice amount of a dry spell, and then all of a sudden the sprinklers get turned on from the heavens above, and then all of a sudden it causes chaos, because the minute that rainwater hits a hot Mojo tyre, Chemistry 101 dictates that the tyre will lose temperature. Thereby, it also loses tyre pressure, which can also be very conducive to the way that the kart handles, the lateral sideways movement in the sidewalls, and also the pure pace that the driver has in combination with their setup. But meanwhile, Yannick Jacobs is trying to close in on Hannes Border for what is P3 on the road. This juncture, Yannick Jacobs not able to find a way past, but I'm sure that when push comes to shove, it'll be a case of not if, it's when Yannick Jacobs pulls the trigger. And that could be very, very soon indeed. So 4.5 minutes to go. Still even Steven, stalemate, still very much front and centre for the drivers that we have on the field today. Battle between Hannes Border and Yannick Jacobs could have a third piece of the puzzle, courtesy of Lauren Seyfried. And Seyfried is just there, just in the camera shot. And is able to close on in. Dennis Thiem, his race has come to an abrupt end. The 4:54 out of proceedings. Leon Arndt has dropped to 12th. Behind Tim Stender, who now completes the top 10. Florian Breidenbach, in the meantime, has put in the fastest lap of anybody, 47.291 seconds. From the Nice Racing driver, the 4:33. And Fabian Bock is coming under pressure now. The gap looks a little bit closer than just under 9 tenths of a second between Hannes Border and Fabian Bock, as there goes Yannick Jacobs up the inside, through the last right-hander on the circuit here at Vickenborn. That was a great little move there from Yannick Jacobs. Up into P3 goes the 401 from Kraft Motorsport. And Florian Breidenbach has closed, well, he's taken the best part of over 7.5 tenths of a second he's just taken out of Lawrence Seyfried on that particular last lap. So Florian Breidenbach looks to end up in his side pods, try and close on in to the 4:39 from FM Racing. getting into the last couple of minutes or so of this race. And Seyfried up the inside of Hannes Border to now take what is fourth on the road. Florian Breitenbach might have an opportunity to get past his teammates at Nice Racing. They're under the same awning. Are the 468 and the 433. Just under 2 minutes to go, and it's a great little dice between these two drivers here, Yannick Jacobs and Fabian Bock. They are on the cusp. Now, the thing is that Jacobs is not in the championship hunt, but he is in the battle for third on the podium overall this weekend. And there is a switchback move that was only an inevitability. Fabian Bock now loses out. That drops him from 20 points on this race to 16. That, to me, speaks volumes. Because the way things are, it's going to be rather interesting how Yannick Jacobs is trying to close the gap to Florian Breitenbach. Now, Breitenbach is currently P6. That will net him P6, I'm just remembering here. It's 10 points. So Breitenbach, 10 points. And, yeah, Yannick Jacobs, that's 20. So, you know, you're looking at it from this perspective, and Hannes Border has just done the biggest gesticulation to say to Florian Breitenbach, come on, man, what are you doing? Well, Hannes Border is way off the championship side of things, and Hannes Border just steamrolls up the inside of Florian Breitenbach. The thing is that if Breitenbach saw a move, he was well entitled to go for it. So your guess is as good as mine. Breitenbach is still challenging for a championship podium. This could be the point where Yannick Jacobs has a chance and Hannes Border is staying ahead of his teammate. Now, oh, hang on a second. I'm just having a look. I'm not too sure if the bumper might be in for Florian Breitenbach. I can't really see from this position. I think that might be in. I think he might have a front fairing. Oh, and that is flat. Ah, yes, that is loose. That is a loose bumper. That could be called a front fairing penalty post-race, so that will cost him 5 seconds on the road. Final lap board is out for the penultimate time, and Mika Metz, just looking at it from this perspective, without any points being deducted, he's on 241. Fabian Bock I think it's enough. I think Mika Metz, him winning this, that secures him the title provisionally. Even when you take into consideration the drop scores, Mika Metz has done enough, and I'm waiting for him to cross the line. I think he's got it. I think that race, won by Mika Metz from Dom Motorsport, has made him provisionally the 2021 DD2 Rotax Max Challenge Germany champion, because I looked at the points and it was 100, so without any deductions or any amendments, Mika Metz just has to cruise to the finish line. So there are your results. Mika Metz takes the win by 2.17 seconds from Yannick Jacobs. Fabian Bock in P3. I think his championship run has come to an end. Lawrence Seyfried in fourth. Hannes Border in fifth ahead of Florian Breitenbach. Robert Chorpian, Mark Bartels, Tim Stender, Marcel Steinert ran out the top 10 ahead of Leonhardt, Alex Fehlenbach, Denis Chalal, Tristan Gebhardt, Jan Ischia, and Dennis Thiem. But I think that victory has secured Mika Metz the title for 2021.